It's Wednesday, time for our weekly legislative update, and this week it's the Republicans' turn, and we welcome Senate President Warren Petersen and House Majority Leader Leo Biasiucci. Good to have you both here. Good to see you again.
Thanks for joining us.
Thank you. President, we'll talk with you. I want to talk about this Texas immigration law because it does apply to Arizona in what you want to see Arizona do involving local law enforcement of immigration rules. First, your thoughts on what the Supreme Court ruled and then what a lower court kind of ping-ponged back and forth here.
Sure. Yeah, Ted. So I think everybody knows this. The Biden administration is failing us on immigration, on securing our border. Even our own governor has said the Biden administration is failing us and the federal government is failing us on securing our border. So you're seeing states like Texas step up and do the job that the federal government isn't going to do. We've had a ruling now that said they could enact the law and then briefly after not, and there is some ping-ponging going on. But to me, what it looks like, I imagine we'll know something by this weekend. To me, it seems like they're going to allow Texas to protect their border because the federal government is failing. What does that mean for Arizona? Yeah. Well, one of the biggest reasons Governor Hobbs vetoed our bill, which mirrored the Texas bill, was her claim that it was unconstitutional. If the Supreme Court holds this up as constitutional, then it's going to be a top priority for us to put that bill right back on her desk and with the expectation that she's going to sign it so that Arizona can protect its border.
And the unconstitutionality as far as the governor sees it and what lower courts have seen, and again, it is going back and forth and we haven't really got a full measure of this, but they're saying it basically, it's unconstitutional because it's federal law and you got local law enforcement enforcing federal law, this kind of thing. How do you respond to that?
Look, I think at some point the states are going to have to do something, right? If the feds are not doing their job, which is their job to protect our border, protect the state of Arizona, Texas, California, if they're not doing it, at some point as a state we have to come in and say, look, we're going to do the job that you failed to do. We did this actually in 2022. HB 2696 was my bill on human smuggling. Same scenario. They weren't doing their job in regards to smuggling. We passed a law in Arizona signed by the governor, and now we're arresting human smugglers. So I think the citizens of Arizona are coming to us and saying, look, if they're not doing their job, we put you into office to do something. And this is what we're doing. We have to do something since the administration is not doing what they're supposed to be doing.
Logistically, how would it work? Because obviously law enforcement in Arizona consists of Nogales to Page. I mean, if you got someone in Flagstaff, a law enforcement officer, how does he or she suspect that someone is in the country illegally?
Yeah, so I mean, that's a great question to ask our sheriffs and our law enforcement. I don't know that the majority leader and I would be speculating on how they're going to do that. They do it the same way they enforce all of their other laws. There's a litany of laws on the book. I could speculate how do they enforce and know how to do all of those laws. There's a lot of things that goes into that. There's probable cause. There's reasonable suspicion. There's evidence that they look at and to determine if there's something there. Obviously, I imagine it would have something to do with their documentation or what they're able to show. Do they have an Arizona license or do they have a license from another country? So law enforcement, that's their job. And if they need help from us, you know, Texas has their law enforcement is confident. Our law enforcement brought this to us. Right. So our law enforcement is confident that they can enforce it and know how to do it. So I have faith and confidence in our law enforcement to be able to do that.
Last question, an original veto. You ready to go back again?
Yeah, so especially if we have four other bills that deal directly with the border, and we're hopeful that she'll sign those bills. The Texas bill, again, depending on the ruling, if the court upholds that, we'll be, I will be doing everything I can to put that up back on her desk in a matter of days.
Let's talk about the Starter Homes Act. Governor vetoed that. First of all, what did it call for, and your thoughts on the veto?
Yeah, I mean, extremely disappointing. You have, for the first time in a very long time, and I know President Petersen can vouch to this, we've been trying to pass something to get these home prices down, and we've been trying for years. And finally, we have a bill that came forward that was bipartisan support, which we haven't seen, I don't think, either in the two or three years. You had literally a split of Democrats in the House and Senate who both got behind this bill. And we did all the things that we knew would lead to cheaper homes, that first home that every Arizonan should have the opportunity to buy. and try to get in that range where it can be affordable. So we were doing things like, we shouldn't require HOAs. You shouldn't be telling somebody they can't have a carport, they have to have an enclosed garage, or their tile on the roof, or their roof has to be a tile and not shingle. These things are not the job of the cities, and they're making the houses prices go up. So this bill is just saying, look, let's get that out of the way. Let's make it a cheaper alternative and get these houses up, build them faster. And unfortunately, she vetoed it. And I wish she would have came to us. She didn't until the 11th hour. And that was the part that was most frustrating.
Is there an argument to be made, though, that you said it would lead to lower prices and more affordable homes? Why not just write that into the legislation?
Yeah, and I think President Petersen can jump on this one. He made this comment.
Please.
I think that's one of the most bizarre and strange questions. I mean, this is about supply and demand. It's economics 101. If you don't have enough supply of something, the prices go up. You don't write into a bill, we shall make homes affordable. That's like writing into a bill that violates natural law. That's like writing into a bill, Ted Simons will become 100 years old. I can say you're going to be 100 years old. You're not going to become 100 years old because I wrote it into a bill. Now, what I can do is lower prices by increasing the supply. This was a huge disappointment. You have, right, by literally 50, as he said, Democrats and Republicans came together to cut red tape, to speed up the price, to speed up the process and increase the housing supply so that prices would go down, to make the homes that our parents bought, homes I grew up in that are now illegal to buy, that you can't buy them. We're trying to make those homes legal for our kids, but our governor sided with bureaucrats instead of siding with our kids. And that's disappointing.
That's an awfully tough thing to say here. She also
sided with
cities and municipalities who are against this as well.
They're the bureaucrats. That's who I'm talking about. Well, they're the ones who created the problem.
Okay.
You know, I've been involved in this industry, Ted. I've seen it firsthand. 25 years ago, you could respond to the housing crisis, to a shortage, in 6 months. The minimum time to get something developed and built is now 4 years. We're seeing some projects that are taking 16 years. The bureaucrats and the red tape is absolutely the problem.
For the first time,
Phoenix is now a high-priced area. We used to always be a low-priced area. For the first time, we're now above the average, and we're one of the more expensive places to build. It's absolutely the red tape and the bureaucracy.
Should the bureaucrats, as they are so described, at the cities and towns who want control, why should they not have control over bureaucrats at the state level who want to tell them what to do?
Look, and I think that's the whole reason this bill is brought forward. I think they've gone too far, right? I mean, I think they've gone to a point where they're putting so much regulation, so much red tape on these things that it's now causing the prices to go through the roof. Where the whole point is, give the customer what they want. And they were complaining, right? They're saying that the yards are not big enough and the setback. If that's what the consumer wants, let them have it. I mean, we didn't compromise safety. We didn't compromise any kind of code. None of that was in jeopardy in this bill. And we even kept the parking requirements the same. So we didn't go to the point of putting the hammer down on the cities. We just said, look, you've put too much regulation. Let's remove some of that that's not necessary, and let's let the market figure it out for themselves.
And with all due respect, Ted, what you said is absolutely false. There's no bureaucrats on the state level telling the bureaucrats the city what to do. You have elected officials who are giving citizens more choices.
You also have, home builders influencing these elected officials, talking to them, telling them their ideas.
Home builders are not bureaucrats,
They're
Ted.
Not bureaucrats, though, but they have influence at the legislature.
And you're not a bureaucrat, Ted. Who do you want to decide the design of your house and what paint color? Do you want to decide that?
I would like
Or would you like a bureaucrat to decide that for you?
If I live in a homeowners association, then I've already made my choice. I don't live in a homeowners association, so I get to make my choice. But that is the choice you make between rules and regulations and otherwise.
So my question is, do you want to decide the color paint of your home, or do you want a bureaucrat to decide it?
I want, if I've lived in an HOA, I want the HOA to decide.
You want the HOA to decide the color of your home?
Of course, if I live in an HOA, I've agreed to that. That's part of the agreement.
Okay, well, I respectfully disagree with you, Ted.
But I don't live in an HOA,
Ted, our citizens in the state of Arizona should be able to decide what color their house is, the tile that goes on their house, and all of the other things over a city. If they want to buy in an HOA that has select things, fine, they can decide that. But a city bureaucrat has no business deciding colors and designs and those kinds of things.
We're running out of time. Last question on this. Is there a balancing point? Is there a way to move forward with this where other side, cities and towns, the bureaucrats, if you will, get a little bit of what they want, and you get a little bit of what you want.
Look, and when we had this first, this Lee came out and said, this is no negotiation. We're not going to negotiate any of this. That I don't agree with that, right? I'm somebody who believes in you get to the table, you figure it out, and you get the job done. As soon as this bill was vetoed, I sent an email out. I said, look, if what don't you like, let's sit down. This is the most important thing that we're facing in Arizona, along with the border, right? We can't just sit here and say we're not going to negotiate. That was a really silly comment to be made by the league that said we're not going to negotiate at all. This is more important than anything else. We got to figure it out. We're happy to sit at the table and figure it out. And the offer's on the table to the governor as well as the league and city.
All right, gentlemen. Well, there's so much more I want to talk about, but we're out of time. Good conversation.
We'll come back.
You're invited back. Thank you both for joining us.
We
really do appreciate it.
Thanks, Ted.